Okay, kids, how are we doing decorating the Christmas tree?
Well, Matthew won't let me put the ornaments where I want.
That's because he puts them on one branch.
Every time I put an ornament on the tree, McKenna puts one right in front of it.
So I like the spots he chooses.
Okay. Let's get a little more organized. I'm going to divide these up into four groups here. Reese, you're the oldest.
So you do the top of the tree. Wyatt, you're the youngest, so you do the bottom of the tree. Matthew, you want to do middle left? McKenna, you can do middle right. How about that?
I bet I'll get more presents than you, Matthew.
Oh, no, you won't. Mom and Dad always treat us all the same.
Well, I think Mom and Dad like me the best because I always give them hugs.
Well, I always clean my room without being asked.
I just came by your room and it's a big mess.
It is because you went in there and messed it up.
Did not.
Did too.
Hey, what is going on in here? This is the Christmas season. It's supposed to be the most joyous time of the year, right? Where you're extra nice and loving to one another.
Well, Wyatt says Wyatt says that he's getting the most presents, and Reese says you like him the best.
Reese, that was our secret, dude. Okay. But I can tell right now you're only thinking of yourselves. So why don't we come over here and sit down? We'll have a lesson on the true meaning of Christmas. Now just sit back, close your eyes, and think about that first night when Jesus was born. Just think of what Mary gave to us on that first Christmas night.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
And then think of the sacrifices Joseph made to take care of Mary and baby Jesus. They had to travel to get away from an angry king, all of this just so we could have a Savior.
I'm sure he must have been surprised how far the road had taken him. 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message of the angel come to life. And Joseph said, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. And why him with all the rulers in the world? And why here inside this stable filled with hay? And why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Well, I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this seems such a strange way to save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? And why here inside this stable filled with hay? And why her? She's just an ordinary girl." Well, I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this seems such a strange way to save the world. Yeah, this seems such a strange way to save the world.
So as you can see, Christmas is all about giving. God gave us Jesus just so we could have a Savior. The wise men searched a long time to give him gifts. So I have an idea. Let's do a little project, and we will make ornaments to take to church and give to our church family and also to the nursing home. When we go to the nursing home, we're going to do our Christmas program, and we'll give them out to the residents. Does that sound good? All right, let's go get started. Okay, is everyone ready to go to the nursing home? Reese, do you have your pants on?
Yeah.
Okay, what about baskets? Does everybody have their baskets with ornaments?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, are we ready to go? Reese, you got your pants on. It's a Christmas miracle.
We're ready.
All right. Well, we're sure proud of you guys, and I think everybody at the nursing home is really going to appreciate everything that we've done. I know God loves a cheerful giver also.
We would like all the residents of the village to start making your way to the meeting room. The youth from the Nazarene Church are here to give us a Christmas program.
Get her outfits on. Come on, Howard. Oh, Nellie, don't rush me. You know I have a bad back, and I gotta take it slow.
Well, I sure hope this program's better than the last one we had. I couldn't hear a thing.
Oh, June, quit your fussing and keep moving along.
I am not cussing, and I'm not going to sing a song.
I thought there was going to be some food here. Nellie, yes. There's no food.
Oh, Howard, don't start.
Cart? Where's a cart? I want some tea.
No, this just needs to go on.
Thank you, dear.
What is that? Thank you.
God bless you, dear.
Good morning, everyone. We got some children here that would like to present their Christmas play to you all.
Why, great. Where are they?
Some cuties there,
they are.
Jesus came to take our sins away. Hey, Christmas bells, ring them all again. Tell the world that Jesus came to take our sins away. Hey! Christmas is a special day, the birthday of the King. J-E-S-U-S, 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 the birthday of King Jesus. Christmas is a special day, the birthday of the King. J-E-S-U-S, 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 the birthday of King Jesus.
I guess they'll be back.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. Joseph also went from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with his wife, who was with child. So it was while they were there that the days were completed for her to deliver. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest,
and of peace, goodwill, and all men."
So So it was when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem. I want to see this baby that the Lord has made known to us."
And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Now when they had seen him, they were made widely known the saying which was told them concerning the child. And all those that heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God.
Praise God.
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in the days of King Herod, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying,
"Come in, gentlemen. It looks like you've come a long way. What can I do for you?"
"Where is he who has been born King of the Jews?"
"We have seen a star in the east and have been following it.
We want to worship him and give him gifts."
"Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you have found him, bring back word to me that I may also go and worship him."
When they heard the king, they departed.
"This cannot be true. I won't let this happen. I am the king, and no one's going to take my place. I won't allow it. Guard. Let me know when they come back. I am getting rid of that child."
And behold, the star which the wise men had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they had come into the house, they saw the young child with his mother Mary, and fell down and worshipped him.
Praise God.
"We have finally found you.
We have followed your star a long way."
When they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him.
"I bring you gold.
I bring you frankincense.
I bring you myrrh."
Then, being warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way.
The children here have some Christmas gifts or ornaments that they've made for you all, and they would like to present a special gift here for a special man. Jerry, this is for you.
I would like to tell Jerry that Willa McCain sewed the blanket, and each of the kids tied it all the way around just for you.
Well, wasn't that just the sweetest program you ever heard?
It sure was. They were so sweet.
Well, Howard, you're still an old softy at heart.
Who, me? Now where's the food?
Howard, don't start.
Oh, thank you. About time.
Well, that was the best Christmas program I ever saw. I heard every word.
What a blessing these children are.
Car? Why, Esther, you can't drive a car.
June, get a hearing aid.
Lemonade?
I like lemonade.
I don't want lemonade.
We would like to thank you all for the great program. Let's give the kids another round of applause for coming to share with us today.
Let me help you, Neil.
That was the best day ever.
I'll go first.
Your part.
I hope we can do something like this every year.
It was so much fun giving our gifts away.
I think God was really pleased with us. We didn't just think about ourselves. We helped others have a Merry Christmas.
You're right, McKenna. You guys did a really good job, and your mom and I are really proud of you guys. Let's always remember to be kind and loving to each other. Even
Aww.
Our brothers and sisters.
Let's have a group hug.
Group hug.
Well, Merry Christmas, everyone. Glad you came to the play, and you surely have things to chuckle about while you eat lunch today. But truly, the children did make ornaments, and these four will be at the back door. So as you leave, if you would like an ornament, please do take one. And then also, Debbie, if we could have you come up just for a minute. And of course, I didn't ask her to do this. She said ad lib and make it have flair. But Debbie wrote, directed, produced this whole stage. And we just want to say thank you, even though God's journey is leading you maybe a little further down the road than we, you know, would choose. But thank you so much. You did a great job, especially with what you had to work with. Yeah. Very welcome. And then one last thing, I think I'll turn it over to Pastor. I think many of you know of Kaya Davis. It was a young woman here in our county that was injured in a car wreck, and they just wanted me to announce that Blondie's is doing a fundraiser for that family today. They have lots of medical bills, and she has lots of surgery still ahead of her. So if you haven't decided where you're eating today, Blondie's from noon to 7, all the proceeds will go to that family. So just an idea for you this afternoon. And then Pastor, if you're, I don't know where you are. Do you want to go?
Well, let's go ahead and give them another round of applause this morning. They did a wonderful job. The interesting thing about plays like this on around Christmas time is sometimes you never know what you're going to get. But it looked like everybody was on cue and on spot, and it went well. We do thank Debbie very much for her hard work and all of the cast for their commitment to the play practices. You know, you may have noticed the last 2 months or so on Sunday mornings, maybe it seemed a little empty in the sanctuary. Maybe some of the people that you're used to seeing weren't here and you thought that they were playing hooky. Chances are they were in the back and they were doing their practice and getting ready for today. So a lot of work and an effort went into it, and we're grateful for that. Before we leave this morning, I want to remind you two verses of scripture, and the cast kind of pointed them out to us, but I was intrigued by them and have been intrigued by them. It's Luke chapter 2, verses 20 and verses 19 and 20. It says, "But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had seen and heard as it had been told to them." What an adventure the very first Christmas must have been. You think about Mary and Joseph having to pack up and leave their what was familiar to them, was really what was home to them, in order to fulfill the requirements of the law to return to Joseph's hometown there in Bethlehem. They get there. There's no room for them in the house that they were thinking they were going to stay at. So the house owner says, you can go and stay with the sheep and the cows. That's the best I've got to offer you. And then far away from what was familiar to them and really where their heart probably was, they welcomed their first child into the world. There's a lot of things. Everything seems to have been stacked against Mary and Joseph. And I would venture to say this morning that most of us that are here today, we may not want to admit this, and you may not want to go around and brag about this, but most of us who are here today, if some of the things that happened to Mary and Joseph had happened to us, we probably would not have been as good of sports as they are. Because I know a lot of you, and I know myself. And we have a tendency to complain and bicker about a whole lot less stuff than what Mary and Joseph encountered on that very first Christmas morning. And chances are, you know, we're into that busy time of the year where there's a lot of things still to do. There are a lot of presents still to be bought, gifts to be wrapped, parties to attend, caroling to be done. And I'm going to be willing to bet at least once between now and the 25th, you're going to be tempted to complain. Now, you can be honest, it's Sunday morning, you're in church, and I'm going to go another step and say, I'm willing to bet at least once something that you have planned is not going to work out the way that you thought it was going to work out. But I wonder today, in the midst of this joyous, most wonderful time of the year, what your response is going to be to life. I wonder today how you are going to respond to adversity. I wonder how you will respond when things don't go exactly the way that you hoped they would. I wonder how you will respond when instead of the diamond ring you wanted, you get a vacuum cleaner. I wonder how you will respond when maybe what you hoped to experience doesn't transpire the way that you hoped it would. I see two individuals. I see Mary, who gets to the end of what had to have been a trying couple of days. And Luke tells us that Mary pondered all these things. That word ponder means that she just really experienced them. She really thought about them. She really treasured them in her heart. They became a blessing to her. It became something that inspired her, something that was an encouragement to her. She pondered them in her heart. Wonder what would happen if we returned to pondering the beauty and the wonder of the season. I wonder what would happen if before we opened up our presents or before we had the Christmas meal, we truly stopped to marvel at everything that God did and everything that God had to endure and go through just to get here to be with us. We wonder what would happen if we marveled at the wonderful gift that God presented to us when he gave us the baby in a manger. And then I think about the shepherds. They had their whole entire night interrupted. They were supposed to be tending sheep. They're supposed to be keeping watch over flocks by night. Luke is kind of poetic in the way that he explains that to us. But they had a job to do. And in the middle of doing the job, their entire night is interrupted when a heavenly host of angels, a choir of angels, invades the night sky. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm telling you right now, if I was out in the dark hillside of Bethlehem tending sheep and it was a starry night and it was kind of cold and I was settled in for the night and the sky suddenly lit up with angels who were speaking, I would put on my tennis shoes and I would run as far and as fast as I could. The shepherds received this angelic message. A Savior has been born. And I don't know if there was a level of doubt in their mind or if it was mere curiosity. But they say to each other, let's go to Bethlehem and check this out. Let's see if what the angels are saying is true or whether we just had some bad salami before we went to bed. And they make their way to Bethlehem, and Luke tells us that when they got there, everything was just as the angels told them it was going to be. And having seen it and having experienced it, they returned praising God for all they had seen and heard. I wonder what would happen this Christmas season. Having experienced the celebration of welcoming the Christ child into the world and into our lives, I wonder what would happen if we left our celebrations. I wonder what would happen if we left our gathering time this morning and went out into the world and joyfully, that's the key word, proclaimed the good news of what God has done for us. Because the reality is God has been very, very good to us. God has blessed us in so many ways. God has sent his presence. He sent his son. He sent his spirit to be with us. And we've got a reason to celebrate. We've got a reason for joy. It's not just the presents. It's not the food. It's not the meals. It's not even our family, our friends. Those are good things. But the greatest thing is the Christ child who invaded our world and came to us. What would happen if we left and we took the attitude of the shepherds who said, we're going to glorify God, we're going to praise God, we're going to tell everybody we know what we've seen and what we've experienced? I would venture to say this morning that our Christmas would be a whole lot different if we pondered and we shared the good news of God with others. My prayer for us and for you this morning would be that everywhere that we go and in every situation that we encounter, whether it goes exactly the way we want it to or whether it gets turned completely upside down, that we would give God the praise and give God the glory and give God the credit he deserves, and that we would be like Mary and treasure these things and celebrate them in our heart. The children have done a wonderful job of reminding us what Christmas is all about. Now it is our responsibility to leave here and take the true meaning of Christmas with us everywhere that we go. I want to thank you again for being here. I also want to extend an invitation. Next Sunday morning is Christmas Sunday morning, as far as what the church world would call Christmas Sunday morning. And if you don't have a church home, we want to invite you to come back and celebrate with us. And then next Sunday evening at 6 o'clock, we're going to do a candlelight service, just a time of celebrating. A lot of carols will be sung, time of reflecting on who God is and what Christmas is all about. We want to invite you to come back and be a part of that as well, and just to join us in celebrating this wonderful time of year. I'm going to invite you to stand. Won't ask Donna to sing a song. She says she's not going to do that. But I want to pray a prayer of blessing for you and your families today before we leave. And then I pray that if I don't see you again between now and Christmas, that you'll have the most wonderful time, blessed Christmas season. Let's pray. Jesus, thank you for coming into our world and for being for us everything that we need. You are our hope, our joy, our peace. You are our salvation. And Father, we thank you for the gift that you gave us when you sent your son. God, help us to treasure these things, to ponder them in our heart. Help us to celebrate them. And God, I pray that you would help us to share the good news and to be joyful about what we've seen and experienced. For Lord, it is exactly as you said it would be. Bless every home and every family that's attended today. I pray the true meaning of Christmas would be alive and well within them. And Lord, I pray you'll give them the best Christmas they've ever had. We love you this morning. We ask all of it now in Jesus' name. Amen.